Florida's manatees are dying at worrisome rates. Here's why. As of mid-January 2023, at least 45 manatees have died in and around the state, almost double the number who had died by this time last year. The giant herbivores, which the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service lists as threatened, are facing a whole bunch of problems. A manatee mom only has one calf every 2 to 5 years, so when death rates are high, it is difficult for the population to grow. Chief among the issues plaguing the species is starvation. Manatees, which typically weigh about 1,000 pounds, eat seagrass and other aquatic vegetation. The seagrass is disappearing due to pollution from human-caused urban and agricultural runoff, as well as destruction from boats and anchors. Manatees suffering from malnutrition are more likely to die in other ways as well, especially in cold temperatures. Boats play a more direct role in manatee mortality too, as collisions are another leading cause of death. Officials are desperately trying to help the sea cows, feeding them thousands of pounds of lettuce and trying to prevent them from getting caught in human-made structures. Governor Ron DeSantis recently signed an executive order proposing to spend $3.5 billion to protect Florida's water resources and Everglades National Park over 4 years, including boosting seagrass populations.
We can't take our foot off the gas. We're going to have to remain diligent to make sure that we're putting into protections, we're creating wild space for them, and also trying to make sure that, you know, we can live with them and they can live with us.